woken us up.
I did. 6 times you were out for the count. What time did you come to bed?
Dunno. Gone 3.
Don't tell me you're on the internet.
I just lost track of time.
Doing what?
Well, you know the DVD of our baby?
Yeah, what about it?
I put it on YouTube.
Come again?
Our baby is a star. Well, say something.
Are you completely insane?
I thought you'd be excited.
Excited? My womb's on the World Wide Web.
Yeah. Getting its as we speak.
Oh, what time are you doing?
Brian said about lunchtime. It's just a half-day induction.
You will talk to Roy first.
Yes, he's next on my list. Now, I'm thinking smart but casual, professional but approachable. What do you reckon?
Yeah, yeah, ticks all the boxes.
Look, come on, it's going to be fine. Trust me. As long as we stick to the story, nobody will be any the wiser.
And if our chair happens to pick up the phone again...
Yeah, all right, I admit that was a little bit too close for comfort. But from now onwards, I'll get the school to ring me on my mobile. Satisfied?
I suppose.
All right, I'm off.
Any going to wish me luck? Do you want to tell him or shall I?
Yeah, John's found a new job.
You're kidding? What's the gig?
It's an admin position in a furniture warehouse.
Factory. It's strictly entry level, but you have to start somewhere.
No, that's great. Oh, you did brilliant.
Thanks, Chess.
Laters.
Bye, love.
See? Went like a dream. Mwah!
And you did this all by yourself?
Joking, are you? I had to log on to one of them nerdy chat sites. Some bloke called the Sky Beast taught me through it.
Can't leave you alone for a second. What were you thinking?
Well, I weren't really.
Well, there's a surprise.
I'm sorry, but I still don't see why it's such a big secret.
Because I've told you, I'm still getting used to the idea. My dad doesn't even know.
Well, tell him to go online. What can I say? I'm in love.
Well, you should have okayed it with me first.
I know.
I'll let you off this one time, but it comes off today and not a word to anyone.
Fair enough.
Go on, get going. Tyrone. I'm glad you're so happy.
Just don't shout it from the rooftops, right?
Something like that.
Got ya.
Decided to grace us with your presence, have you?
Sorry, alarm didn't go.
Look at that, sir. You look rough.
Yeah, I had a bit of a dicky tummy. Teach me to eat Molly's cooking, eh?
Are you okay to work?
Yeah, of course.
Look, I meant to ask you, how did the scan go yesterday?
Oh, top. Got a DVD and everything.
Oh, nice one.
And that 3D, it is the business. It's like you're inside there with a baby.
I bet. Look, are you okay, mate?
Yeah, never better. Right, what are we doing?
One bacon.
Any chance of a quick word, Roy?
One moment. Is that balm rolled, toast or plain sliced?
Balm tar.
Balm.
Bacon and tomato.
Bacon and tomato.
Fried egg. Low fat marge.
One egg, skinny spread.
If all works for me. All right, Mum.
Ty, there's my notepad down there, mate.
Yeah.
Cheers. You okay?
Yeah, got something to show you. Skis over. Oh, Wish I had a drum roll. Kev, I'd like you to meet my son.
I'm really sorry to spring this on you.
No apology is necessary. I always anticipated that your term of employment would be somewhat temporary.
I just feel like I need a new challenge.
Yeah, you're a young, intelligent man. Of course, you must seek pastures new.
Well, I hardly call Rochdale pastures new, but it's a start.
May I inquire as to the nature of your new occupation?
Yeah. Yeah, it's an admin job in a furniture factory. Just office stuff, you know, filing, answering the phone, that sort of thing. I'm hoping for a more defined role once I'm established.
So, a complete departure, career-wise?
Yeah, well, like you say, it's time to move on. Anyway, should let you get on. Thank you for everything.
Every success. May I wish you fortune and fulfilment.
Who's that?
Ah, just some bird I met with withdrawal symptoms. Top yaffle, right?
Yaffle?
It's scram food, you know, it's army slang.
Oh, you're so cute!
Well, Mum, you're embarrassing us, come on.
Oh, I'm sorry, I just can't get over that you're here. We weren't expecting you for another fortnight.
Yeah, well, they had to move our leave dates around. Something about a new intake was dead sudden.
Well, even so, a phone call would have been nice.
Yeah, well, I didn't want to spoil the surprise, did I?
I was planning a hero's welcome.
Maybe next time, yeah?
I wanted this to be special.
Well, I'm home, aren't I? What's more special than that?
You're not just saying that.
I'll tell you what. Make me steak and chips for tea. We're even, yeah? Go on, you best get back to work.
Oh, don't be daft. You've only just got here. Besides, Roy can cope.
Well, he's your boss. He shouldn't have to.
Listen to you, old duty and responsibility. You've grown up.
The army has taken my boy and he's brought me back a man.
Mum, don't start. Look, I best be off.
Oh, I'm so proud of you, Gary.
Oh, amazing with that. Did you catch him waving at us?
Talk about quality.
Can you believe that's what's growing in Molly's tummy? And I know it's a bit mad showing the whole world, but he's beautiful.
Yeah, gonna have to duck out for a bit.
You all right?
Yeah, fine. I just need so much weight, won't be long.
Hey, up, Kev. You in? You all right, son? You look like you've seen a ghost. Kevin, are you okay, lad?
Shouldn't have shown him that scan.
No, you shouldn't have. I'm sure you're blowing it totally out of proportion.
You didn't see him, love. He was well choked up.
Sorry, it doesn't make sense. Why would something like that upset Kevin?
Well, isn't it obvious?
No, not really.
Our kid's a boy, Rosa and Sophie are girls. You do the maths.
I'm not with you.
Oh, come on, think about it, Mol. All blokes want a son, it's like genetic or something. And I know he's chuffed for us, but still, it must hurt.
Yeah, well, he'll get over it, won't he? Oh, well, I remember. Did you get a chance to check the car? Because I'm not changing trains three times just to get to my dad's. Earth to Tyrone.
I have just had the most mega awesome idea ever. We make Kevin, wait for it, our baby's godfather. What do you reckon? Big mate, great father, works for me.
I'm not sure.
What's there not to be sure about? You can wish for a sounder bloke.
I know, but...
So what's the problem then?
Well, for starters, the baby's not even been born yet.
So?
So, I don't want to tempt fate by making such a massive decision.
Yeah, fair play.
Let's just wait and see what the future brings, eh? Not saying no.
You're just saying not now.
Yeah.
Talk about wake-up call. Feel like Tyrone's kicked me in the guts.
Serve you right if you did.
Thanks, Dad. You're all that.
Look, she's having that kid. End of story. I can't understand it. Yesterday you were so sure.
Yeah, well, yesterday the baby went all over the flaming internet.
So? Look, I don't care if Tyrone's taking out a two-page spread in the sun. It's not your problem. You have to move on.
I've seen him. He's real flesh and blood. How the heck am I supposed to ignore Molly after that?
By telling yourself that he's not yours. By focusing on your own life, with your own family.
It's not that simple.
Of course it isn't. It's hard. But if that's what you've got to become inside, then maybe that's the price you have to pay.
Do I know you? You should be locked up, mate. Is that guy a perv or what?
Wilson!
This weirdo were giving us a funny look.
Yeah. No, weirdo, as you so delicately put it, is Mr. Fishwick, your new English teacher. I suggest you apologise immediately.
Sorry, sir.
Now, do one. You have to excuse Wilson. The lad's a work in progress. You made it then?
Yeah.
Nervous?
Something like that.
Just be yourself, Col.
I reckon Nick might go for a bit of colour.
Oh, I can't be doing with this. I am an artist. I don't judge hair, I reinvent.
Oh, Natasha, sweetheart, you hardly even know my grandson and already you're trying to change him.
Women don't change men, we improve them.
Yeah, well, a lot have tried and failed with our Nick.
Really?
Don't get me wrong, absolutely adorable. Oh, I love him to bits. But when it comes to relationships...
He's a handful.
I just think you ought to know what you might be letting yourself in for.
Oh, so you're not trying to put me off?
Oh, I long since given up interfering with my family. No, as long as it doesn't interfere with your work, love, be my guest.
Afternoon.
Oh, hi. Well, what are you doing here?
Well, I found myself in the neighbourhood and suddenly desired your company.
Oh, give up.
You fancy a drink?
Oh, sorry, I can't. I've already got plans.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm meeting someone in town.
Really?
Yes, she's an old friend.
Oh, well, in that case, there's nothing else for it. I'll just have to pay for your company.
Hiya.
Hi.
Do you need a shampoo?
Hair wash, sir.
I give a fantastic Indian head massage.
Well, that sounds delightful, but just a quick spruce up on this occasion.
No worries. You fancy a brew?
Oh, a coffee, if it's not too much trouble, my dear.
My dear? Just for that, you're getting a cafetiere.
Be gentle with me. Please.
Fizz. Oh, sorry. I just want to offer my congratulations on John's new job.
Oh, ta.
Oh, you must be so close.
Huh? John Boy's got a new job?
Yeah.
Well, you kept that quiet.
Yeah, well, it's hardly front page news.
Here, Fizz's fella's only gone and landed himself a new gig in a furniture factory.
You're John in a factory?
Oh. Admin? A white collar? Oh, that explains it. Can't see him on a production line.
Blaming no chance. They'd eat him alive.
How did he find it?
I'll do an old schoolmate, apparently. Oh, friends in high places.
Does he get staff discount?
Oh, trust you to ask that.
What do you reckon, Faith?
Yeah, I'll see what I can do.
Well, I can't speak for this Nick chap, but in my experience, settling down is easy. It's finding the right woman willing to settle for you. That's the tricky bit.
And have you?
One lives in hope, my dear. One lives in hope.
Right. All done. Come on.
Oh, just as I was beginning to relax.
Oh, if you really want to relax, get Ord to give you a manicure. Ooh. Talk about therapeutic. No kidding. The woman is a miracle worker.
Natasha, shush. Just
a sales pitch like that. How could I resist? Transport me to heaven.
Oh, you heard the gentleman. Top up.
Thank you very much.
Excuse me, what do you think you're playing at?
Come off it, you can't pretend you're not enjoying it. Anyway, I've always wanted to hold your hand in public.
Oh, behave.
Hiya, Gran.
Oh, sweetheart.
Please take a seat.
Oh, you must be the dashing Nick.
You say so?
Well, the name's Lewis. Good to meet you.
You too.
Take a seat.
Thank you.
Chuck us a multimeter, Kev. Cheers. Fancy a brew?
Nah, you're all right.
Look, I'm sorry about earlier.
For what?
I know that video was a bit weird for you. Molly told me to keep it to myself.
Look, you're excited. Forget about it.
I'm only showing you because you're my mate.
Okay.
You're my best mate.
Cheers. Means a lot.
You've been like a rock to us.
Right, steady on.
I'm weirding you out again, aren't I? Flipping heck, I'm turning into a chick.
Yeah, well, Harvard runs a big step. You've got a lot of stuff to take on.
See, that's what I'm talking about, you understand? Been there, done that, next. That's why you're the perfect choice.
Perfect choice for what?
Look, if I tell you, you can't say out tomorrow.
Fair enough.
Well, brace yourself. I want you to be the godfather. That's right, mate. You heard me. And I don't mean Marlon Brando.
I've always had a soft spot for Nottingham. I managed the Regent Gentlemen's Club for a couple of years. Oh, heady days. The best blackjack table this side of Mayfair.
The Regent? I can't say I know it.
I believe they changed the name to something Egyptian sounding.
You don't mean pharaohs.
The very one. Of course, back in those days, the words gentleman's club actually meant something.
So you're still in the casino business?
Oh, no, not for a few years now. Oh, I'm what you might call semi-retired.
I have always fancied trying that croupier look.
Well, it's all in the digits, my dear. An ideal hand must be fine-boned and delicate, yet reassuringly strong. In fact, much like Audrey's here. Well, and on that note, I shall take my leave.
No, you haven't had your second buff yet.
I've monopolised enough of your time already. Right, what's the damage?
No.
£25, 15 for the cut, 10 for the manicure.
Call it 30. Good to meet you, and good luck with your new enterprise.
Thank you.
I'll see you out, come on.
Nice guy.
I hope it takes one to know one.
Oh, save by the bell. Hello, Nick Tilsley.
No, I'm sorry, Carla, I can't.
Look, I hope I didn't embarrass you too much in front of your grandson.
You were charm personified, as well you know. Actually, I'm not particularly comfortable except...
Nonsense. You're worth every penny. Just like me.
Oh. Well, I'm glad you called in. It was a lovely surprise.
Well, perhaps we can do it again.
Yeah, perhaps. As long as no money changes hands, eh?
I'd like that. To the next time. Bye, Audrey.
Bye. You are well in there.
Fizz! Fizz!
All right, keep your hair on. Oh. Good day, I take it.
That school is incredible. Weatherfield High doesn't hold a candle to the place.
Great.
Facilities are first class, state-of-the-art classrooms. The teachers, talk about friendly. Basically, everything that Bri described.
Bri, is it?
Yeah, we kind of bonded this afternoon.
I'm glad for you.
Well, you don't look it.
Well, I'm sorry. The girls found out about your new job.
Oh? And?
And I told them what we agreed. You wouldn't believe how made up they were for you.
Well, so there's no harm done.
Yeah, I felt terrible. Oh, yeah, this will be the Queen, this, offering a congrats.
Come on, Fizz.
Hello? Oh, hi. Yeah. Yeah, he is here, just let me check. Colin? Have you got your mobile?
Who is it?
That would be a no, Brian. Oh, no, no. There's no need to put yourself out. No, honestly. Well, okay. OK, well, if you insist. Right, see you then. He'll be here in 20 minutes.
All right.
Look, seriously, Ty, life's tough enough as it is without giving your kid that sort of baggage.
He'll be a great godfather.
No, I won't. Look, I'm not religious. I'd feel a hypocrite.
We can work around that.
Well, you're going to phone the Pope up?
Look, I just want another bloke in his life that he can trust and look up to.
Well, you think that's me? Ty, this is nuts.
Well, at least think about it.
Look, I'm touched. I am. But I don't want to be anyone's moral guardian.
So, in other words, you're turning me down?
It's just not for me. I'm just being honest.
Out of order, more like.
What?
You heard me. This is important to me, Kev.
Oh, come on, Ty. Don't take it so personally.
Of course it's personal. You're blowing out my son. What sort of mate does that?
The sort who's sick to death of listening to you gibbering on about your kid. I've got news for you, Tyrone. You didn't invent fatherhood.
All right, calm down.
You know what? You're right. This isn't working. Maybe we're not the mates you think we are. Maybe we should call it quits right now.
What are you on about?
I want to dissolve the partnership. I want you out.
And Coronation Street continues in half an hour.